All right, so in this program we're going to use an array to store some scores for an exam, for several exams actually. So for example, let's say a student in this course, where we take 3-unit exams, would like to record his or her scores and get an average of the exam scores. So here I'm being prompted to enter my score for exam 1. So let's say I studied and I got 90% on exam 1. Okay, and then for exam 2, let's say I got busy in the semester and I didn't study as hard and I only got 75%. And then for exam 3, I really hit the books and studied hard and I got 100% on exam 3. Okay, and then here's my summary. We have our exam scores displayed back to the user. We have the average, which is about 88%. And, you know, what's going on behind the scenes here is the exam scores went into a small array of just 3 elements. And we were able to also get a running total of the scores and then divide it by 3 at the end to get the average exam score. So this is not a long program. We'll go ahead and write it. Okay. It's very common to want to loop through an array and get maybe an average from the array or a total from the array when you have numeric values in the array. So, you know, when we want to get an average of anything, we have to first get a running total of that amount, and then we divide it by the number of items that we're getting an average of. So let's get some kind of total variable and set that to 0. So that'll be our first order of business. This is going to be the running total that we use for our average. Okay, running total for average. And then what we'll do is we'll set up the loop that will get the user's input from the text window here. So we'll say for, I'll use loop counter I, for example. For I equals 1 to 3, we know we have 3 exam scores. Again, you could leave that more open-ended as opposed to hard-coding a 3, but we'll just hard-code a 3 here. We have enough to think about in this application. So, all right. So I'll be prompting, we're doing a few things in this loop, prompting the user to enter the exam score, actually getting the exam score and putting it into the array, and then also we can use this loop to get our running total of exam scores. So let's start with prompting the user to enter an exam score. Okay, you don't want to say something like this, enter score for exam 1, because you want that to change. You want it to say here, I'll show you real quick. Enter score for exam 1, fine, okay. Now it's enter score for exam 2. Notice it's changing as we're going through the loop. So you don't want to hard code a 1 or a 2 or a 3. What we can do is, once again, use our loop counter to get a changing value here. So for exam, and then we'll concatenate I to that. And then we'll continue on with the rest of it, which is really just a colon. Okay, so that'll make our input look very nice, actually. So this is the prompt for the user. All right. Now, what is the user going to do? He or she is going to enter the score at the prompt. And typically, like, okay, before this unit, before we knew what arrays were, we would do something like this. Score equals text window dot read number, right? Okay. However, the score is going into an array. So why don't we call the array scores? And of course, when you have an array, you have to specify the index of the element that the score is going into. Now we're looping through the array, so we're going to use our loop counter as our array index here. So the first time through the loop, I has a value of 1. That first score for exam 1 is going to go right into that first element in the array. Second time through the loop, I takes on a value of 2, and the score that is entered will go into the second element in the array. So it all works out. And then the third thing that we can accomplish in this loop is to get that cumulative total that we will ultimately divide by 3 at the end. So again, we created this total variable. We initialized it to 0. So total equals total plus, and then whatever score just came in, which we can access through scores with the index of I. This is a very common thing to want to do in programming, is to get this cumulative amount or cumulative total. And really what this translates to is the total is going to be whatever's in there already plus the new value. Okay? So the first time through the loop, let's say the student got 90% and entered a score of 90%. Total is going to be set to whatever's in there already. Now, first time through the loop, it's 0 plus the new score, which is 90. All right, so the total has 90 in it. Second time through the loop, total is going to be set to whatever's in there already, which is 90 now, plus the new score. Let's say it's 80. So then, you know, the new total is, what, 170. Okay, so let's move out of the loop now. And we can, I guess, do the average right away. We'll say average equals the total divided by 3. Okay. I hard-coded a 3 because we know we're dealing with 3 exams, and we hard-coded a 3 here, too. That's fine. All right, so why don't we just grab some blank lines here. So I've entered the 3 exam scores. This is taken care of by the first loop. All right, now in the bottom here, we'll loop through our array which is now populated with the 3 exam scores. We'll loop through it. We'll print out the exam scores. I have a tab in there. I use the tab character so we can line it up kind of nicely like a table. And then lastly, we'll print out the average there. So let's do another loop here. Whatever loop counter you want. Let's use Z, just because we can. For Z equals 1 to 3. Again, hard coding a 3, that's fine. All right, and then we'll write the code that'll print one line from the from with the exam score. Okay, so we'll say if you look at our output here, we have exam 1, exam 2, exam 3, not hard coding those values, but let's use our loop counter Z to create that effect. So we'll say exam and then concatenate to that the Z. Okay, and then we have a tab after that. So that Z is going to produce these numbers here. And then we'll tab over and print the actual score. So this is text.getCharacter. And then the character code for the tab is 9. All right, and then finally, we will print the actual score, which is coming from the array. And we will once again use our loop counter as the array index there. All right, so that will produce this little table of scores here. And then lastly, we'll print the average. Now notice I'm outside of the loop now. Because we're going to print the average, that's not part of the code that should be repeated. Anything you put inside of the loop is going to be repeated. We just want one line here at the bottom of the program stating the average. So that's what we'll do. So we'll say text window, write line. And then we already computed the average up here on line 11, and we put the result there in AVG. That should do it. Let's try it out. Oh, you know what? I forgot to close my parentheses here. I opened the the paren and then went through this long spiel and then I forgot to close it at the end. So, all right, so what do we have? Okay, let's say first exam got 85%, second exam really studied hard, got 95%, third exam, same thing, 100%, and there we go.